Jennifer Williams, a Mississippi mother, was having trouble covering her expenses on a school teacher salary. So she turned to a so-called payday lender.
I started with $200, and then when it was time for me to rewrite, I increased it to $400, and that was the start of my payday lender journey.
That one loan turned into how many loans?
At the end, I had a total of 9.
Payday lenders provide customers like Williams with short-term, small-dollar loans. But unlike traditional banks, they don't require credit checks or consider whether a borrower can reasonably repay loans. The catch, shockingly high interest rates, often as much as 400%.
It caused me so much stress, so many headaches, nights of crying, trying to figure out how I'm gonna get to the next pay period.
So you called it quicksand. How would you characterize that cycle?
I put it like a habit. You need it.
That quicksand is trapping a lot of borrowers. One study found that 76% of payday loans are used to pay off previous ones, a revolving door of debt with increasing interest. While lenders say they're providing a necessary service to help people with these small loans, many consumer advocates call the industry predatory.
They are designed to be a debt trap.
Lauren Saunders is the associate director of the National Consumer Law Center in Washington, D.C.
How do these types of loans perpetuate a cycle of poverty?
They perpetuate the harm we've seen in communities of color who have been deprived of income and assets.
In Mississippi, where Williams lives, there are more payday lenders than McDonald's, Burger King's, and Starbucks combined, according to state estimates. And a new study concludes the industry overwhelmingly targets Black and Latino communities in advertisements. Some states are taking steps to help. So far, just under 20 states and Washington, D.C. have passed laws restricting interest rates that lenders can charge on payday loans. This summer, Hawaii capped rates and fees at 36%. And while broader federal legislation has stalled, Darren Williams, CEO of Southern Bancorp, an Arkansas-based lender, says institutions like his are already helping consumers.
People need access to small dollar lending. There's a more responsible and responsive way to do that.
His bank runs a learning center that offers financial classes, free tax prep, and low interest loans.
Low wealth people also want to build wealth. And so if we can help you save and start accumulating wealth and pass down for generations, then we can help break this cycle.
Jennifer Williams says Southern Bancorp's program worked for her.
What were the lessons you took away?
We went through topics as small as bringing your lunch to save money instead of going out and then buying a meal every day, or grabbing water instead of buying that soda, creating a monthly budget. We had a plan to address our financial situations and a new start on life, honestly.
Experts say if you need help, check online for available financial literacy classes. Many are now offered on Zoom. Ask your credit card or utility company for a repayment plan and save any windfalls, like your annual tax refund, for an emergency fund.
They prey on the vulnerable or the weak.
For Jennifer, who took out her first payday loan in 2008, it took about 8 years to get out of debt.
How did it feel when you paid off all of those loans?
I can't even describe it. I got my life back.
So many lenders out there. So it's a buyer beware. Really know the terms, the interest before you take out one of these payday loans. Two tips from financial experts. One, don't be ashamed if you have debt, and consider turning to a friend or a family member before a payday loan. So many borrowers say that's what they wish they had done. And number two, seek out a credit counselor. They are a fountain of knowledge. So much great advice for how to form a budget and also help you get out of debt.
So, yeah, so Vicky, you know, you watch this and you wonder, can anything more be done? Has this gotten on the radar of state or federal lawmakers?
Yeah, that's a great question. So back in 2019, federal lawmakers introduced a bill. This would have capped interest rates for consumers at 36% across the nation. But that bill, even with bipartisan support, has stalled. So now, as you see, states are taking it into their own hands.
Thanks for watching our YouTube channel. Follow today's top stories and breaking news by downloading the NBC News app.